Canadian MC Drake isn't just a rapper, he's a corporation. As one of the biggest musical acts on the planet, face of his own brand October's Very Own, and a budding TV executive, Drake has reminded us time and time again that he'd be nothing without his friends. Without 40 Ollie, there'd be no me. Imagine if I never met the
broskies. God's plan. God's plan. Nobody really that I've ever considered a true friend has switched up. But these, like, you know, these fly-by-night people that you just come across, they're all not to be trusted.
So we decided to put together a lyrical guide to the broskies. Drake has hundreds of bars mentioning friends, but the most important are his inner circle.
My main homie's working. Shout out to Nico, Oliver, 4040. Jazz, Tez, CJ.
Loyalty and friendship are incredibly important to Drake, and many of his early hits talk about keeping a small circle, like DJ Khaled's No New Friends and his solo track Over. No new friends, no new friends, no new friends, no no new. DJ Khaled! Still here with my day one nigga, so you hear me say, no new friends. I know way too many people here right now that I didn't know last year. Who the fuck are y'all? We start with his day one, Drake's right-hand man, Nico Carino, who's been with him since the very beginning.
Well, I came up with Drake when he first started rapping. He was kind of acting at the time. OVO is more of a collective. My role, I was like one of the founding members of October's Very Own. So now I'm all in Nico basement putting working on the
phones. Either that or drive the money more to make the pickups. Drake's been riding with the same people since way before his first album, Thank Me Later. And he used the liner notes of his studio debut to thank those who helped him along the way to the top. Of Nico, Drizzy wrote, quote, "Our friendship is what keeps me alive and focused. I always thought I was an only child, but my mother lied. I didn't trust no one, so I got limey cause got too greasy. Nico never moved Nike, sweatsuit Nike, sweatsuit DG." Up next is Drake's engineer and close friend, 40. But here we are and it's a new semester. 40 the only one that know how I deal with the pressure. The two first met in 2005 while working on a record for singer Divine Brown after an introduction for rapper Socrates.
And so he got Drake to come in and do a remix. And Drake and Boy Wonder came to the studio, and that's the first day I met Drake.
And the two have been tight ever since. On Thank Me Later, Drake wrote, quote, "You are the cornerstone of my entire life, and I'll spend the rest of my years trying to figure out how to thank you." And 40 is a regular lyrical shout out. Life is sounding crazy, 40 on Martin Scorsese, and I wouldn't change a thing if you paid me, man. Real nigga, what's up? Next up is Oliver El Khatib, Drake's co-manager and co-founder of October's Very Own.
Oliver, being the genius that he is, goes, "Well, look, I got this kid. Come downstairs in the rain and listen to this kid. His name's The Weeknd." Ollie North pulling like 10 million a season.
Queen Street visions that nobody believed in. Known as the lead in many of Drake's business ventures, like OVO Fest, the flagship store, and more, El Khatib credits it all to hard work.
Long hours, scary hours. I watched others going out, spending money, while I invested it in myself, surrounded myself with good people, with good intentions.
On the Thank You Later booklet, Drake wrote, quote, "Thank you for being an amazing friend, a hard worker, and a forward thinker. You have built us a skyscraper from the ground up, and I look forward to spending my entire life and career by your side." Another Drake comrade is his tour DJ and co-manager, Future the Prince. I'm managed by my friends that I grew up with. I'd rather get that 15% of people I fuck with. If me and Future hadn't made it with this rapping, we'd probably be out in Silicon trying to get our billions on. Future and Drake go way, way back.
He got into music and I kind of stuck by him and believed in him, and he believed in me, and you know, that's how we got to this point.
But possibly the person closest to Drake is the one protecting him, Chubbs.
If they moving shaky, we just do the shit ourselves. Well, if I'm moving shaky, Chubbs will do the shit himself. Yeah.
As Drake's head of security, Chubbs is the muscle behind and in front of Drizzy. And if things get crazy, Chubbs will handle it. In the Thank Me Later liner notes, Drake wrote, quote, "Chubbs, thanks for risking your life every day to ensure my safety.
Cameras pointing every time I look up. That's why I gotta duck behind Chubbs' shoulder just to hit the cush up."
Outside of his inner circle, there are a number of other friends that show up in Drake's lyrics. From Baka Not Nice.
That's Baka, he's a no long talker. Quick to let the motherfucking text slam.
To his early collaborator, producer Boy Wonder.
Boy Wonder, I swear it's like this every single time. Toronto, I got you. I got us.
To even LeBron James.
Some niggas been here for a couple, never been here again. I'm on my King James shit, I'm trying to win here again.
And on their end, their loyalty is returned twofold from Drake. On his recent release, When to Say When, Drake hones in on the reason he stays faithful to his day ones.
You just need to stay close to your people that was there when others could have been, there when others should have been.
Is there anyone we missed? Let us know in the comments. I'm Jacques Morel with Genius News, bringing you the meaning and the knowledge behind the music. Peace.